Did you approach Gravitas, or did they approach you?
We have a sales agent, Prince Films, and who their duty is to get our film sold to different territories and things. And I think Gravitas, Igor Prince reached out to Gravitas, and then they made an offer that was suitable for us, and then that was for North America. So it's being distributed, you know, through all streaming platforms, cable and things. We had a limited theatrical release plan, but in LA and New York, but that got, you know, squashed. But again, you know, we're super thankful for just to reach daylight. Considering what so many other filmmakers are going through and having their films shown up this year, and not even going through the festival route with all the virtual festivals and things like that. We were lucky to start our festival last year run, and then it ended earlier because of the pandemic. So, but we were able to get North American distribution.
Did you have to sell the film in any way to Gravitas, or because you went through this sales agent?
So you kind of sort of you have your film, and you could either sell it through different territories or worldwide. And so Igor, he does the dealings for that. You can go to Gravitas yourself, I believe, or any distributor. For that matter, you know, you don't, it's, I would equate it to having, if you built a house, you could sell your house by yourself, or you could get a realtor, they get a commission, things of that sort. So, usually when you have sales reps and they have relationships prior to, you know, because you're bombarded usually by a lot of films, some people answer the phone more than others. And then Igor took our film through all the different markets, you know, Toronto, Cannes, different things. So they would have booths set up, and film buyers would take a look and things like that. So that's the advantage, I would say, with having a sales agent who is there to help push the sale of your film. But we went with Gravitas because they had, you know, good favorable terms. There were you know, nice folks. And it was also, you know, a situation where we, you know, we still have international rights as well.
How has COVID impacted your filmmaking career?
Let's see. I think just in terms of in general, just personally and professionally, you know, it's puts everyone at a pause. To, you know, we talked about earlier, like, to see what is important in life. What do we want to do? It kind of makes you think about those kinds of things. How it personally has affected my filmmaking life is, I think when you go through the process of owning a business or trying to make a film, there's always a monkey wrench. And if you could survive the monkey wrench, and if it hasn't taken your legs out and you're still standing, you keep trudging along. I try to have that state of mind and mentality. Okay, if I can't do this, then there's something else I can do while this is happening. I could write, I could research, I could think of ideas, I could, chill out, you know, balance life, maybe spend more time with family. More, not be so self-absorbed and go. So those are the things that we all have to question ourselves every day. And then, you know, I was just talking with my wife the other day. It's like, feels like I've been running for 10 years running, and it just feels weird to not run because you're just so used to it. Then, but sometimes you need to just relax and take it off and recharge and think about, you know, others beside yourself and your career and what you want to do. And you know, it's like, that's that's, I hope to try to be better at, and as we all try to navigate these crazy times. And so yeah, I hope, you know, we, like I said, we still have our pencil and notepad and final draft, and we could still keep writing.
Yeah, sorry, I have to bring up this, it's cliche, but just the scene in Forrest Gump where he's running and everyone's like, oh, he stopped, okay, wait, hang on, he's gonna speak. And then all he just says is, I'm tired now, I think I'm gonna go home.
Yeah, that movie is excellent in every single way, and because those scenes, those moments are relatable. It's like, that's why all these great songwriters, the great screenwriters, they do something so simple, and it makes you feel like you can do it. And that's the best part. To write a song to make you want to go and learn how to play a guitar, that's amazing for everyone. So that have Forrest Gump or Princess Bride or do these things, and you're like, hey, that's something I want to do, you know? Whether we ever achieve that's not the case. It's just you want to give it a shot. And I think, you know, COVID kind of, for those who even were thinking if it's difficult out there to try to be a filmmaker, just find your half-price books and buy a book and read and write, and don't think about what's happening in 10 years. Think about if it makes you happy today, and if you could write a story, you know? I think that's the important part.